This is episode 2 of my old RV to smart RV conversion, and today I'll add a TP-Link 4G wireless router, a Raspberry Pi 4, and I'll install a home assistant and a Garmin navigation plus Garmin wireless backup camera. I'll try to show you the software and the hardware part of all of this, so if you happen to like what I did, you'll be able to replicate that and to do the same or better in your RV, your boat, your home, or whatever else you have. This is the lineup of the things that I'm about to add in my RV. If you like something and you want to check their current prices, I will leave affiliate links in the video description. With that being said, let's start this. First thing is this circuit breaker with the fuse reset. I'll connect that immediately after my batteries. What I like about it is that it looks very solid and I can cut the power to everything that will be connected after it with a push of a button. Then I can restore it like that. I bought that from AliExpress for around $6. Next is this 12 slots fuse box. I'll connect this box after the circuit breaker and I'll connect my router and Raspberry Pi here. This box is again from AliExpress. It costs around $18. There is a more compact version with 6 slots that I should probably have to choose, as I'm not sure that I'll use all 12 slots. But as they say, the more, the better. Next thing is a 4G wireless router from TP-Link and a 4G modem from Huawei, which is Vodafone branded. This router is cheap. It is around $25 and it can work on 12 volts or even 6 volts. I'll cut the power cord and I'll connect the router directly to my RV batteries, which is a big plus. I considered some more expensive options, but then I decided otherwise, as this router is confirmed working good by me. I'm using such in my villa for years on AC and it is working pretty stable. On top, there is a nice looking Home Assistant TP-Link integration that I can use to send SMSs, which is going to be a great for notification service in my future Home Assistant automations. But more on that later, as the brain of our operation is coming. This is going to be the main smart home hub for my RV. It is a Raspberry Pi 4 with 4G of RAM. I'll connect it to my TP-Link router with a LAN cable. And to power it up, I'll use this 12V to 5V and 3A converter that I bought here in Bulgaria for around 6 euros. Nevertheless, I'm pretty sure that this is coming again from AliExpress, and I'll search a link for you if you're interested. I will use a SD card for the Raspberry Pi storage, but a good one, SanDisk Extreme. This SD card cost me around $16. I will not use SSD drives for this Raspberry in the RV, as I'm not after some extreme speeds and I don't need much disk space for the Home Assistant. Quick side note, I had this Raspberry Pi already and I use it for a test Home Assistant environment. Now I have to find something else for that purpose. But anyways, there is a global deficit of these Raspberries lately. Or they're available somewhere, but they're quite expensive. I'll try to find some good deals and I'll put them in the video description if you want to get one. Before I install the router and the Raspberry in the RV, I'll prepare everything here in my studio. And by everything, I mean that I'll configure the router and I'll install Home Assistant on the Raspberry Pi. But more on that in a minute. The final things that I'm about to install are this Garmin DriveSmart 65 navigation and this Garmin BC40 backup camera. To be honest here, I mainly use my phone for navigation and I bought this Garmin stuff only because of the backup camera. The Garmin BC40 camera cannot work with smartphones and it is only compatible with Garmin navigations, and to be precise, only with some specific models. And this Garmin DriveSmart 65 navigation is in the list of compatible ones. The installation of this camera and navigation is extremely easy, but unfortunately, a potential unwanted removal aka theft, is extremely easy as well. But you see that later. Now I'll configure the TP-Link wireless router on a fast pace, as there is nothing unusual here. I'll open a new tab and I'll type 192.168.1.1 as an IP. And this is the page of the router. I'll type a new password here. And I'll click on Let's get started. I have to select my time zone here. Next. 3G, 4G router mode is okay. Next. And as you can see here, my 4G modem is unplugged and I'm going to plug it now. Identifying. And few seconds later, the modem is successfully identified and I can click Next. All other things I'll leave it as they are without any changes. I'll enable wireless radio. I'll leave the network name and password as they are for simplicity, but I'll change them later. And I'll click Next. And this is my summary. Wireless network is enabled. This is the network name. And I have this 3G, 4G router mode. I can click Save. And everything should be okay now. I can test the internet connection. And my test is a success and I can click OK. Finish. To double check that everything is OK, I'll open another tab and I'll open my website. Good, it is working. Time to install the Home Assistant on the Raspberry Pi. I will use the Home Assistant OS method to install it, which is the most popular way of doing that. But I have to say, this method is not the only possible way. There are three other official and supported methods of Home Assistant installation, and I'll talk about all of them in my Home Assistant webinar, as well as their pros and cons. On top in the webinar, you can see one super simple way to get Home Assistant up and running on your PC in under 5 minutes. The webinar registration is now open and it is completely free. So go register right now. I downloaded the Raspberry Pi Imager, which is available for free on raspberrypi.com website. You can download this for macOS, Windows or Linux, and I'll start it. This is it. I'll click on Choose OS, I'll scroll down, and I'll select this Other Specific Purposes OS section, then Home Assistant and Home Automation. And here it is, Home Assistant. I'll select this one. I'll choose the first option here because I'm using Raspberry Pi 4. I'll insert my SD card into my SD card reader. And I'll choose this card as a storage. And then I'll click Write. Simple as that. It will ask me, do you want to continue? Yes, of course. I'll type my password here. This is something macOS specific. And the writing begins. That's it. When this SD card is ready, I can insert it into my Raspberry Pi 4 and boot it up. I'll insert the SD card into the Raspberry Pi slot like that. The case, by the way, is also from AliExpress. And this is a Raspberry Pi camera. Version 1.3. I'm not sure why I use it, but I have it and I'll leave it like that for now. Now, I'll connect my Raspberry Pi to my router via LAN cable, just to configure everything. I'll power on the Raspberry Pi like that. It is powered. I'll power on my router. I'll connect wirelessly to my router, my TP-Link router. This is the Wi-Fi network that I created. I'll change that later probably. I'll type the IP of my router. I'll log in. And I have one wired client, and this wired client is my Home Assistant. And here I can see my Home Assistant IP. If I type that IP in another tab, colon 8123 as a port, because this is the default Home Assistant port, I should see the Home Assistant preparing screen, and this can take up to 20 minutes. If you don't want to check the IP in the router, you can try the following trick. In another tab, just type homeassistant.local:8123 as a port, and it should open the same thing. Of course, this depends on your router and it may not work, but for the TP-Link, it seems okay. After some time, this screen should pop up where I can set my Home Assistant username, like that, and password. I can set my location, I can set my currency, my name here of the installation. I'll set that later. I can enable here the anonymized analytics of Home Assistant, but this step is entirely optional, of course. On this step, Home Assistant is trying to auto-detect some integrations and devices that can work with Home Assistant, but I skip that for now and I'll click finish. And this is it. This is my Home Assistant. Smart RV Home Assistant. As I said in the beginning, this Home Assistant installed on a Raspberry Pi will be the brain of my RV. My goal here is to connect everything possible to the Home Assistant, and I'll add a lot of smart sensors in the next episodes. But now I want to show you the Garmin navigation plus Garmin backup camera installation. The best thing about this setup is that no wires are required for the installation. The only thing that I don't like about this camera is that it can be stolen in under 2 seconds. But the good things are a lot. The resolution is higher than the usual backup cameras, as it can go up to 720p. I must say that the video quality and the video angle are quite good. And after all, having a good image can be the difference of hitting something or not hitting it when driving backwards. Avoiding just one obstacle due to the better video quality can save you a lot more money than the price of the camera and the navigation itself, don't you think? Also, this camera is battery powered with two regular AA batteries. With them, it is stated that can last up to 3 months. To show the camera image, I have to power on the Garmin DriveSmart 65 navigation and to press this button. Voice commands are also supported. Show video. And it is working. I bought the Garmin BC40 backup camera with a camper mount, but there is also a mount for license plates and pipes, so it is versatile enough to mount it on almost every vehicle out there. You can see the current prices of the navigation and the camera in the video description. These are the new cables, the negative and the positive. They are going to the circuit breaker, and from there they are going to the fuse box. This is the fuse box, and from here I power the Raspberry Pi and the router. Now the only thing that is missing is this 4G modem. Now you can see that the 4G modem is connected and I have internet here. If I want to disconnect the Raspberry Pi and the router and this fuse box, I just have to press this button and everything is immediately turned off. I have no power. To turn the power on back, I have to move this and I have power again. I can put this right here like that. Let's try to connect to the Smart RV network. Here it is. I'm connected now. And let me check if I have an internet. Yes, I have. This is my website. And if I try to open homeassistant.local and 8123 as a port, I'll see my Home Assistant, which is working perfectly, and now I'm ready to add some smart sensor and make my RV smart. And now my RV is having Home Assistant inside and it is smart sensor ready. From the next episode, the things will finally start becoming smarter. Meanwhile, you can download my smart home glossary, which is full of simple but useful explanations of the most common smart home words and abbreviations. You can download the smart home glossary free of charge from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Many thanks for all the messages and comments that I received after the episode 1 of the Smart RV Conversion series. This helps a lot, as I have some experience with Home Assistant, but I have very little experience with the RVs. So, any help and advice from you, especially when it is from experience, is highly appreciated. Here is, for example, something that bugs me at the moment. The bathroom needs a renovation. I found a technique called RetroBright, where hydrogen peroxide and ultraviolet sunlight is used to brighten the plastic to a degree that it looks like new. I bought some hydrogen peroxide, but clearly I cannot expose my RV bathroom to the sun, and now I'm looking for a suitable UVA light. If you happen to know about such ultraviolet light, or even better, if you did something similar, share that in the comments. Anyways, if you missed the first episode of this Smart RV Conversion series, go check it out right here. I'm sharing there the current state of my camper, its price, what are my plans, dreams and intentions. In the next episode, which will be the third one, I'm planning to add some smart sensors in the RV and to add these sensors in Home Assistant, so I can control them and make some automations. I also have plans for a lot more things about the RV that you are about to see soon. Subscribe for this channel with the notification bell if you don't want to miss them. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!